Greenland is set to lose more ice than in 12,000 years. Yeah. Professor Michael Mann is on with us. Check this out. Leave your comments. Ding the bell. Share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Dr. Mann, welcome back. Tell us about this study.
Yeah, thanks, Tom. Always good to be with you, my friend. You know, this is the latest bad news. To be honest, it's not that surprising based on what we already knew. We knew things were pretty bad. Two summers ago, in July, enough ice melted from the surface of the Greenland ice sheet that over that one-month period, you would be able to see the rise in global sea level from that. The human eye would have been able to see the rise in global sea level from 1 month of melt from Greenland, about a half a centimeter. Sounds small, but Whoa. We could actually perceptibly see sea level increase, and we are decades ahead of where we expected to be, given the model predictions from, say, a decade or so ago. We didn't expect to be seeing the collapse of large parts of the Greenland and West Antarctic ice sheet for decades. But over the last several years, what we've seen through a variety of measurements, direct in-situ measurements, satellite images, we can detect the changes in gravity owing to the melting of the ice. They all point towards the Greenland and West Antarctic ice sheet losing substantial ice already, enough so that our sea level rise projections have gone from, let's say, 15 years ago, we were talking about a foot by the end of the century. Now we're talking 6 to 8 feet and maybe more than that. And so what this study does is it just puts all of that information in context. They use climate models to estimate how the variations in ice sheet mass, what those variations were in the past. We don't have direct measurements of that melting ice from Greenland and West Antarctica. We do have some ice core measurements that help give us some information about what was going on. And so what they did is to run climate models with ice sheet models that know something about the information provided from actual ice cores to give us a history of how ice melt varied over the past, 12,000 years. And there is no precedent for what we're seeing now. I hate to say it, it's another hockey stick, just like our hockey stick curve from two decades ago that showed the anomalous nature of recent warming. They produced a hockey stick that shows just how anomalous this rate of melt is already. And if we continue on the course that we're on, then indeed we're looking at substantially greater amounts of melt than we expected to see at this point. And so all of the evidence is coming together. This study provides us context to see that what's happening right now is not normal. It's not part of the natural variability of the climate system. It's completely anomalous.
So we're just to be explicit, I'm guessing the vast majority of people watching or listening to us right now know well the cause of this. But for those who may still be uninformed, why is this happening?
Yeah, and that includes our president, unfortunately, who just the other day conceded, to my knowledge, for the first time that climate change might be having some role. Well, in fact, climate change, human-caused climate change, carbon emissions from fossil fuel burning and other human activities are responsible for all of the warming that we've seen. That's what the models tell us. And the impacts that we are seeing play out in the form of, an unprecedented hurricane season back east, an unprecedented fire season out west, and as we see with this latest study, unprecedented amounts of melting from the ice sheets that, are very troubling, because what that means is we've already locked in several more feet of global sea level rise. We're going to have to deal with that in the best-case scenario. In the worst-case scenario, we're starting to look at this, the literal inundation of millions of people around the world from sea level rise if we don't get our act together.
Now, I saw on Facebook the other day that this is actually being caused by sunspots, and the sun is more active than normal, and the Earth has a normal change in its orbit where it gets closer to the sun and farther away from the sun periodically, and that's what's causing all this, and we should all just, this is just natural stuff. It might be tough, might be difficult, but hey, 12,000 years ago something like this was going on. That's natural. We weren't burning fossil fuels back then.
Yeah. And we heard sort of a version of that from the president the other day, where he dismissed the linkage, for example, with the wildfires, between climate change and the wildfires, dismissing it as, I guess, we don't have enough rakes to rake the leaves. That's still, you know, his framing of this very obvious and detrimental climate change impact. But in terms of natural factors, if you take those same climate models that I was talking about and you drive them just with the natural factors, solar fluctuations, volcanic eruptions, etc., the models tell us we should have cooled over the past few decades. Natural factors were temporarily pushing us in the direction of cooling, and we've warmed as much as we have in spite of that. So if you really want to know how much of the warming we are responsible for, it's more than 100%, because natural factors, if anything, have actually offset a little bit of the human-caused warming.
Professor, we just have a little more than a minute left. I've also seen stories recently that the Arctic is now on fire, that there are fires up in the Arctic that are burning continuously, like the old peat fires, you know, of lore. And that in Antarctica, one of the major ice shelves, or one of the more major glaciers, I guess, on land, is fixing to break loose. Are the polar regions in crisis?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the truth is bad enough. Everything you've described, those are simply the facts. We're seeing accelerated collapse of ice shelves up Antarctica, and that's allowing the Antarctic ice sheet to start to melt and contribute to sea level rise faster than we would have expected. The same thing in Greenland, as we've already discussed. So they're already contributing to sea level rise decades ahead of schedule relative to what we were predicting, say, a decade to two decades ago. And wildfires from the Amazon all the way up to the Arctic. As I've said before, it's not rocket science. You make things hotter, you make summers in particular drier, you're going to get more fuel or more intense, more damaging, more extensive wildfires, and we're seeing it happen right now.